Hey guys, and welcome to Neat Video Tutorials. In this tutorial, we're going to walk you through the basic workflow in Neat Video 6. We'll cover the steps you'll be using in most cases. So if you've just started using Neat Video, this tutorial is the perfect starting point on your way to clean and noise-free video. Let's get started. To achieve the best possible noise reduction, we first need to inspect this clip and find a frame with large uniform areas showing strong noise. This frame looks good. There's quite a bit of noise, and it also has some featureless areas here. Now, let's add Neat Video. In Premiere Pro, go to the Effects panel, Video Effects, Neat Video. Drag and drop reduced noise onto the clip. Click Prepare and Build. To find Neat Video in a different video editing software, check out our quick start guides. You'll find the links to them below. Next, we need to build a noise profile. Click the Auto Profile button and check whether the automatically selected area is suitable for profiling. A good area should have no visible details, should be large enough, and should contain clearly visible noise that is strongest in that frame. The noise level indicator helps confirm the noise strength. If these conditions aren't met, manually select a better area and click Build Profile to create a new one. Once you're happy with the selected area, click the Profile Check button. Here, you should see a clean image with no visible noise. The image will look a bit blurry, but don't worry, it's only temporary. If you still see noise or artifacts, increase the noise level slider and stop as soon as the noise is gone. Going too high can make the results blurry. For more info on profiling and noise profiling, check out another tutorial linked below. When you're happy with the profile, go to the Adjust and Preview tab. You'll instantly see a filtered version of the clip. Click on the preview to see the original image. You can also use the Play button to view the result in motion. This will help you decide if you are satisfied with the result or want to make further adjustments. To fine-tune noise reduction, use the Temporal and Spatial filter tabs. The Temporal filter compares nearby frames to distinguish noise from detail. Increasing the radius gives the filter more data to work with, which can produce cleaner results, though it will slow down rendering. Once you've adjusted the Temporal filter, move on to the Spatial tab if needed. Here you'll find sliders for the noise reduction amount and noise level. The noise reduction amount sets how much of the detected noise the spatial filter will remove. By default, it's set to 40%. You can increase it, but be cautious. Going too high can make the image look overprocessed and lose detail. If you set this amount to 100% and still see unwanted noise, try increasing the noise level instead. This tells the spatial filter to expect more noise than originally estimated. Raise the noise level until the noise disappears, then adjust the noise reduction amount again to find the right balance between reducing enough noise and preserving fine details. Again, avoid setting these controls too high. We also have a sharpening tool here. When enabled, it can help restore some of the image sharpness after noise reduction. Now, let's check the before and after difference with Neat Video. I'll just select a frame in the viewer. As you can see, the change is dramatic. Once you're happy with the result, click Apply. Remember, nothing beats trying it for yourself. Experiment with profiling, tweak the filter settings, check your results, and adjust Neat Video again until you find the look you love. If you want to go deeper into noise reduction, tuning filter settings, flicker reduction, and other advanced tools, check out our advanced workflow tutorial. That's it, guys. We hope you found this tutorial helpful. Please hit the subscribe button and give us a thumbs up. If you have any questions, leave a comment below. We'll be happy to help. Bye for now.